I need more time to prepare.
It's just like what you told back home. That small class last year here. But that's what they want you to do tomorrow. Give some different insight on African literature. Something quite different for our students here. These are the keys for my colleague's home. You can prepare in the classroom, D008. I gotta run. I'm sorry.
Literature, that is my weapon. Teaching other people's stories that they could not. Crime is my arrogance. Literature, that is my weapon. I believe they could not get to me. The classroom is sacred. African people's stories. I want to bring a Nobel Prize winner out of... Literature, teaching our stories, other people's stories, this is my weapon. When I say literature, you say weapon. Literature!
Weapon!
Literature!
You could bring your wife as well. You've always dreamt of moving, right?
But visiting is one thing.
Yeah, but you are the only one...
Thank you.
You were the only one in your family who went to university. You were born to try somewhere else. Be a true outsider, and believe me, here you will be an outsider.
Mubashi is my home.
Yeah. With the rebellions and the endless war.
They can't touch me. I'm afraid to start over.
I'm afraid to try your navel, I see. Just think about it. Leave me.
I'll try the Ineva. They won't touch me. They can't. Perhaps down in his heart, Congo was not a cruel man. But his whole life was dominated by fear. Fear of failure. And of weakness.
Professor, I don't understand what Ajayi meant by men being weak.
What does it mean to be weak? See, Ajayi teaches us there is no story that is not true. The freedom is in that, in the mind. And they can never take that away. Excusez-moi?
Felix Kaputu?
Yes. I am still teaching. Maybe it is better if you come back another time.
Do you know this book?
It is one of the classics.
Uh-huh. Maybe you like to write your own book, huh? Speak so much. Democracy this, democracy that. Now, what do you say, Professor?
I am sorry, I do not understand the charge.
Do you deny you went to Europe to buy weapons?
What? This is crazy. I'm a professor.
Your friend, the president of the university, has already confessed. The charge is treason and raising your own army of rebels. These are dangerous times to be raising armies, Professor.
Armies? What armies? I create armies of the mind. Minds free to all.
I don't give a damn if you live or die, but I will get you to confess first. Now sit down. Are you okay? Are you okay?
If I were you, 8212, I would write.
My name is...
Number 8212. Number 8212.
I don't know how long we will be out. Could be 18 years. With the death penalty if he's convicted. Personally, I try all the best to help him and clear all charges. Huh? Why are you so concerned about him?
He is my husband.
Ah, literature lovers, huh? We know what they're like. Students tell us he bewitches them. Male students. You are a good-looking woman.
Professor Usef, this is a man formerly known as Felix Kaputu, number 8212. They are trying to take over my mind.
She is my home.
Professor, so what's your lecture on today?
Chinua Achebe wrote, if you don't like my story, write your own. They have a death warrant for me. What the hell? My name is Felix Kaputu, and this is my story. I thought they could never touch me.
Somebody has to decide to leave one one's country. It's not with pleasure. Look at my case, for instance. Once I left the Congo and was in Boston, I had to visit a psychiatric hospital 48 times. I needed to detach myself from so many things I was attached to in my country, like the profession itself, the students, the environment, the family, etc. So it takes time. I chose to be a professor, to be a teacher, and I still love that a lot. And by being far from my country, I found new opportunities to be able to get deeper in the culture of my people, to know better Africa in order to explain it to others. So, what seemed very bad at the beginning, and is indeed bad, somehow for my case, changed in something very positive today, and I ended even this year presenting another PhD, which could be a good addition to what I knew before. Institutions such as the SAR, the School at Risk Network, and others dealing with academics are quite important to build that network which raise awareness about what is happening to academics around the world. Academic freedom is very important around the world if we want the world to survive, if we want the truth to be standing on the front line. It is my hope that the film will be distributed to raise awareness that academic freedom may be protected.